I'm back. Welcome back to my channel. Okay, so yeah, today I'm gonna make banana pudding. I've been waiting to make this banana pudding. Y'all don't understand. I've been waiting so long. Okay, I've been waiting. I'm like, no, I ain't gonna make it. Yeah, I'm making it. I ain't gonna make it. I'm making it because I am about to start a diet. And I'm not starting no diet until I make this banana pudding and until it's gone. I'm not gonna start it and not even get to eat it like that or whatever. So yeah, I just touched my hair, so let me get up and go wash my hands and let's get into this video. Okay, so first you want to get vanilla jello pudding, okay, and you're going to need some milk, so I got brand new milk here, and you are going to need a bowl, so I have a bowl that I just rinsed out, it's dripping water over me, and you're going to need a whisk, okay, so the first step into making the banana pudding is you want to open up your jello pudding, the vanilla flavor. So I'm just opening it here. Let me put this in front of the camera. I'm like opening. Y'all can't even see. So then you want to pour it into the bowl. And get all of it out. That's the good stuff. You don't want to waste any of it, okay? I'll be trying to get everything out. Let me see if I can turn this camera so y'all can see, okay? Okay. So we want to get all of that out. Once you have put all of that in, you want to add 3 cups of cold milk. So I have my little handy dandy measuring cup here. Okay. And I'm going to add 3 cups. So this is a 1 cup. That seemed like a lot, but okay. We're going to go with it. 2 cups. It smells so good. I wish y'all could smell it through this video. And that will be the 3rd cup of milk. I'm going to stick this in there a little bit because I got some powder on the bottom of it. Okay. I'm making a mess, y'all. Don't judge me. Sorry. All right, and then I'm going to take my handy-dandy whisk, and I'm going to whisk away. You want to make sure you don't have no lumps. And all of that, make sure you're mixing everything up. But don't splash it all over the place. Like last time I had my daughter, and I'm trying to show her how to cook, how to make different things. And she was throwing stuff everywhere with her whisk. So what I do is I point my whisk down. If you point it down, then you're not going to splash everywhere. Even if you would move fast. See, I'm moving fast. But I'm putting my whisk downward so I ain't splashing. Now, what would be funny if I splash right now? Because I'm telling y'all that it won't splash. But yeah, just point it downward, and then you won't have that problem. If you still hear that gritting noise like that, that means that you have not did it enough. What they recommend is that you whisk for 2 minutes. So I'm going to whisk this thing for 2 minutes, and then I'm going to get back to y'all, okay? Okay, so I'm done whisking. The box recommends that you, like, wait 5 minutes. So it can like soft set, but I don't think I'm gonna wait 5 minutes, y'all, because I'm ready to get this thing in the refrigerator. I really wish I could eat some tonight, but I may have to wait till tomorrow. I was hoping I could take a little bit with my lunch because I already packed my lunch for work, but may not work out. So yeah, if you hear now, you don't hear that gritting noise that you heard before. So we made sure that we got everything. I just want to go around in there one more time just to make sure, okay, that we have everything. Alright, so we'll let that sit. I mean, we don't really technically have to let it sit. They say let it sit for 5 minutes, but okay. I guess just because I'm doing a video, I'll let it sit for 5 minutes and then we'll come back. Okay, so the other thing that I do, you know, I make my banana pudding different ways every time, I'm gonna be honest with you. But I like to put a little condensed milk in there, just because that's how my grandma did it. So I'm going to open this condensed milk up. And we'll put a little bit of condensed milk in there just to make it yummy. And also, you got to be careful after you put that condensed milk in there so you don't be splashing all over the place. Remember, you can point your whisk down, and that way you won't splash. I also like to rotate my bowl. I got that from my daddy. My daddy makes really good cakes. It's actually my family recipe, my grandmother's recipe, and she gave it to my dad at one time. And I used to help him when I was a little girl. He makes really good cakes. He actually sells them and makes a lot of money doing it. Well, he used to. He don't do it anymore. But, yeah. So, I rotate my bowl a little bit. Okay, I think that's good to go, y'all. I'm not going to make no big banana pudding because, truth be told, I'm going to be going on a diet soon. So, I don't need all this banana pudding here at the house. So, I'm just going to use this container here. That's all I'm going to use, okay? I'll use this container to make the banana pudding. I'm trying to shift stuff away. Okay, so this is an important ingredient. You want to make sure you have your vanilla wafers. I know y'all seen these in the store before, okay? They're usually right beside the bananas because they know what people want to use them for. So I'm going to open these up. But my hands are kind of sticky. I don't know how that happened. And I like to line my bottom. Line my bottom. So you want to cover the whole bottom of whatever you're using to put your banana pudding in. You want to cover the whole bottom with cookies. I'm just going to pour some out. I feel like that's taking too long. So we're going to pour some out over there. And I like a lot of cookies in mine. People like different ways, you know. Some people don't like a lot of cookies, but me, I personally like a lot of cookies in my banana pudding. I think the more cookies, the better it tastes to me. So, y'all have seen me use it probably this whole box. I make them for my cousin, and when I make it, that's what he wants for his birthday. So, instead of me making gifts, he wants me to make a banana pudding because he really likes my banana pudding. This one broke, so I'm going to eat that one, no joking. But, yeah, for his birthday last year, he asked me to make him a banana pudding, so I surprised him. I made him two, and he was really happy. He liked a lot of cookies in his, so I actually used two boxes of cookies when I made his, and he was so thankful. He was just talking about it the other day, actually. He might have been throwing a hint. I don't know. Okay, so I lined my bottom all the way. Now, after you line your bottom, you're going to do layers. So, you want to do pudding. You're going to do cookies, pudding, banana. Cookie, pudding, banana. Okay, so we did that. Now it's time for us to come in and put a little bit of pudding. And so it's in this bowl, so I'm just going to try to pour it the best I can, y'all. Don't that look good? Yummy, yummy. Okay. I'm trying to let that drip off just because I'm greedy and I ain't really trying to waste anything. Okay, I want all my stuff. I'm just drip some of that milk in there, but it's okay. Alright, so the next, you're going to want to do your bananas. I'm going to cut the camera off for a second just so I can get situated for these bananas. And I'll be right back. Okay, so I don't even know if I'm using the right knife, y'all, but we have so many different knives. What in the world? My husband. My husband is a chef, so we have so many different like kitchen utensils and knives. It's ridiculous, but you want to make sure you have a clean area to work in or use a chopping board, cutting board. But I'm also cooking dinner at the same time, so I'm already using the cutting board and it had meat on it, so no. I'm just going to use the table and I made sure that it was clean. And these are some big bananas. I usually wouldn't get them this big, but I sent my husband in the store and I guess he didn't want to bring me no small bananas and me be mad, so he just brought me gigantic ones. Okay, so I open the banana up, and I like to just do it a little bit at a time. And then you just want to cut thin slices. I'm trying not to cut into my table, but this knife ain't no joke, so I don't think I got a problem with that. Actually, I bought my husband this knife. Was it for something? I think it was for Father's Day. I don't remember what it was for, but it was like a knife set. It's a Copper Chef. don't know if y'all can see that, but Copper Chef. And it's supposed to be like a really good knife for chefs, and you can do all these different things with it. I have no clue what you can do with it. I have no clue why they have these holes, but if you do, you can leave it in the comments. So after you have cut your bananas, then you want to place your bananas just like you did the cookies. You just want to place your bananas all over the place, all over the place. Okay, you don't want to make them too thick. Like, this one's too thick. Y'all see that? That's too thick. So, I'm just going to eat it. Maybe I just wanted to. I don't know. But, whatever. Don't judge me. Okay, so I'm going to cut up some more bananas. Because you see, that didn't even really do nothing. Okay? That didn't... I mean, it probably made, like, cover, like, half of it. But... So, I'm cutting more bananas. And this time, I'm going to make sure I'm not cutting them thick. So, I don't have to eat them. Or pretend like I gotta eat them because they're thick. Can y'all see that? I hope y'all can. I hope y'all can. I'm gonna tell you, I can't. The way I got this camera set up right now, I can't even see it, what y'all seeing. So I'm praying that y'all can actually see this. It's gonna be crazy if I think I'm shooting a video and I'm not. So yeah, I'm putting the rest of the bananas all up in here. Make that thing yummy, yummy for my tummy. Okay. My husband should be home soon. I'm trying to finish this before he get home. He had a rough day today. And so I said, you know what? I'm going to make this banana pudding that he's been wanting. All right. So remember I said layers. So we did cookies. We did pudding now. And we did bananas. So now it is time for the cookies again. This one's broken. I don't like putting broken ones in there. I guess it don't really matter. It's just the way I am. I feel like if they broken, I can just not put them in. Or I can use it for the top. Because on my top, I crushed the bananas up. I mean, bananas. Lord help me. I crushed the cookies up on the top. So if they're like broken already, those are good to be crushed up. You know, they're already basically crushed anyways. I'm doing the entire, I really don't think y'all can see, so let me try this. Oh no, bad cookie. Okay, I think that's a little bit better. So, continuing to cover the banana pudding. And move this out the way and continue to cover the banana pudding with cookies. Those cookies stuck together. I like a lot of cookies in mine. Okay, so we did cookies first and then we did pudding. So we're back on cookies. So you know what comes next is some more yummy pudding. And I want to make sure I cover everything. And I really tried not to make a big one this time, man, for real, because I got to get on this diet plan. If y'all got some good diets that work, drop it down below in the description or in the comments, I mean, because it's time for me to lose a little weight. All right, so I did cookies. I did pudding. So y'all know what's next. One of these big old huge bananas that my husband bought, another banana. So I'm going to open it up and cut this bad boy up like I did the other one. Okay, and once I cut it up, I'm gonna place it. All on top. I don't like the end of the banana that look like that. I don't like that, and I don't even eat that. I can't. That might be a little weird to some people, but I'm me. All right, so I'm gonna cut the other half of the banana up. And I cut this one too thick. It didn't spread like it's supposed to, but it's okay. If I was to run out of bananas, I have like four more in our fruit basket. So that would be okay. I could just use those. All right. I'm trying to place bananas everywhere. Bananas, bananas. I know this thing about to be so good. And I can't wait. I'm opening a third banana now. slicing and dicing with this knife. This thing go through these bananas like they are nothing. So I'm making sure I don't cut myself. I say I don't eat the end of the banana, y'all know that. So, all right, and then I'm gonna put. Okay, so on my last go around, y'all, I can take this out of this vanilla box. On my last go around, y'all, I just want to put the rest of this pudding, if I can get it out. It done got so thick. Like, the longer it sits, the thicker it's going to get. So, I just want to put some more of this pudding on here. If I can get it out. And you want to try to make sure you cover all the spots, which is kind of hard after this pudding is sitting, because it does not, it gets so thick it don't want to come out. And I'm kind of moving it around a little bit because it kind of lumped up. I mean, that's what it's supposed to do. So I'm taking what I did, put on here, and moving it around so everything can get covered. All the bananas can get covered. And this is how I do my last layer. And I just kind of spread it. Okay, and the very last thing, oh, this banana need to be covered, honey. That the banana's sticking out. Okay, the very last thing, see, this is the bowl. I try to get it all out. Sometimes I let my daughter eat this if she wants. But the very last thing I'm going to do, see, these are the wafers that I have left out of that bag. And I just want to crush them up. Some people take, like, a knife or anything and just, you can take anything you want. And some of them is going to get through the bag, and that's okay. Some people like theirs like powder. I don't like mine too crushed up. I still want to, you know, have some big chunks too. And then I just pour it all over. If I see something that's too big, I'll take it and kind of like break it apart and stuff like that. Okay, so this is how I make my banana pudding. It's going to be so yummy. So then you put this in the refrigerator. It needs to sit in the refrigerator and be chilled for at least 4 hours. So, yeah. What time is it right now? Let's see. It is 8:11. So at 12:11, which I probably will not be up anymore. So I would probably just eat this tomorrow because it needs to chill for at least 4 hours. Okay, so this is how to make a banana pudding from scratch. Hope you enjoyed this video. Bye.